Today I'm working with Christine Adolph's new adhesive rub-ons that were released in January 2016. The imagery included is really interesting, and as you'll see, they're suitable for use with a variety of media. Whether you use the rub-ons as the focal point for a standalone home decor piece, or you incorporate small parts of the imagery into a larger project, you're going to get really nice results. I spent a fair amount of time working with Christine Adolph's new adhesive rub-ons, and I have to say I really do like the process. I especially like the imagery that she's included. There's just a wide assortment of things, from little standalone pieces to pieces like these flowers here. This is from one of the sheets. It looks kind of like burlap, and you can see that I've used iCraft Decor Foil here, but it's not the only thing. Prima has their own line of foils, although foil is foil. You can use whatever you have, whichever you prefer, color you prefer. But in addition, you can use flocking, you can use metal leaf, and you can use glitter, which, as you know, appeals to me greatly. So I'm going to show you the foil and the glitter today. I've also used embossing powder with it, and it works perfectly well. So if you want to talk about this, you really do need to start with the basics. And to do that, I'm just going to bring in, this is a package that I have open, and you can see I've used a fair number of elements from it. From this package, if I bring out the one that has not been opened, you'll see that there are a variety of images, and here is some text. So all I did to get these was I took a piece, this is one of my art cards that hasn't progressed to the point of being finished, so I took, and let me do it here and I'll show you, I took a piece of the acetate with the adhesive on the back off of the sheet and placed it on here, and then I went and put some foil on it. Now, the thing you need to bear in mind, when you work with most rub-ons, they're not adhesive, so you can touch the back. You definitely don't want to touch the back of these. I can tell you from experience that things go wrong. In addition to that, you want to make certain that your hands are clean. If you've got anything on your fingers and you just touch the edge of that adhesive, I can guarantee you it's going to pick the color up off your finger. So this is just a little test so that you see the process. Inside every package comes one of these popsicle stick kind of applicator doohickeys. So you're just going to go along and press this down so that you get good adhesion between that adhesive and whatever you're putting it on, so that it sticks in place and you can remove that clear acetate topper. Now, I will tell you, I have found that this product works the best on nice, smooth surfaces. So I think this is pretty good, and I'm just going to start to gently lift this. And if I see the adhesive come up, I'll come back with the little popsicle stick and go ahead and rub it in place. Anyway, I found that this works best. The smoother the surface, the better the transfer seems to be, which isn't to say that you can't use it on other surfaces, but I think you're going to get better results if you use it on something really smooth. So let me bring in a piece of this. I want to say that this is pink melon, I think is what this is called. So now I'm going to repeat the same process, but this time I'm going to just, you don't have to press super hard. It's one of those you'll kind of find the way that it feels and how it should feel, so that you get the adhesive onto your backing, or excuse me, onto your surface, so that you can get the backing paper off. And then it's kind of the same process here. You're just going to rub gently. You want to get good adhesion on here. Now, if you can see, I've used other parts of this. If you don't get perfect coverage the first time, meaning you have pieces of adhesive that don't have foil on them, you can always go back and rub again. Even if I take this off and I don't have perfect coverage, all I need to do is take another spot where the foil is, there's plenty of it and it doesn't have big gaps in it, and I can come back, I could pick this up, I can come back and I can rub again. So what I did to create these was I took this card like this and I just cut heart shapes out of it. And then if you are a fan of our blog, if you look at our blog, going back to the 26th, I think, of March, it was the last Friday in March, just before Easter, Bonnie Irvine had a blog post, and one of the things that she showed was how she cuts out, she cuts out her elements and then she places them on black cardstock and cuts them out again. So it creates this really nice frame, which you can actually see better if I do this. So that's all I did here. I just obviously want to make certain that the words, the text is kind of aligned properly so it reads the right way. Not that you can actually read it, but you get my drift. So that's one thing that you can do with it. Now, a lot of people ask me, what do you do with all those tags you make? And honestly, I do lots of different things. Sometimes they end up in a drawer until I decide what I want to do with them. So here is, this is another one of these sets. And honestly, they don't have names printed on the packages. They only seem to have numbers. But this is the one with the seashells and the kind of the ocean-oriented theme. Now, I've already cut this off. What I'm going to do is put this on here. Now, I can tell you, in this case, because I know I'm going to cut this out and use just the piece afterward, it really doesn't make a darn bit of difference if this is on here straight and actually I can see that it's a little bit crooked. Because I'm going to cut this out, I'm not worried about that one way or the other. But you can see that the process is very simple, very straightforward, and it's the same. It doesn't matter whether you're using Decor Foil, Primus Foil, if you're using embossing powder, or if you're using glitter. You're always going to come through, and the first thing you've got to do is get that adhesive applied to the surface. Again, I can start to peel the acetate away. Just go ahead and lift that, and you'll see the adhesive kind of lifts up and it gets kind of stringy, so you'll want to just pull this off gently like this. Oops. And that's another thing I wanted to mention. I'm kind of glad that I did this, even though I feel like a bit like the village idiot for having done it. And of course, now this isn't going to want to come off. Let's see if I can get this off a little bit at a time here. I can't, so I'm just going to pull this off. So this is a word to the wise, don't let that happen. Don't let this happen to you. I can still cut this off and it won't make any difference. When you take these pieces off, why can't I find what I'm looking for? When you take these pieces off, don't lay them on anything but this backing paper. Don't let the acetate fall back onto the adhesive, or onto the, at least to the other side of the adhesive, or the other side of the acetate to the adhesive, because bad things will happen. As I said, I can still use this without it. Really doesn't make any difference. So I'm going to come in here. This is, I want to say it's iCraft Deco Foil. I think this color is called Aqua. So I'm just going to come in and do the same thing again. And you see how simple this process is. I mean, it really is super easy. It's not difficult. There's no deep thinking that needs to go on here. All you have to do is choose your design and whatever color foil you want to use. All right, so let's start pulling this off. I could get it to come up. There we go. Now again, you're going to ignore the mess up there that I made, but how pretty is this? You get this beautiful shiny foil, you get this wonderful imagery that Christine has created, and you can see how basically effortless it is when you don't screw it up. This is a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper that I printed a couple of weeks ago. It's watercolor paint that I put on the gel press plate and then I printed, and it allows me to get this really interesting random background that requires really no effort at all, and I do a much better job this way than just slapping colors on with a brush. So that's kind of how this background came about. And then I tore the edges so I got this kind of decal edge look all the way around, and the plan is to make a little standalone collage that I can then put in a journal someplace on a page. What I've also done is put, this is one of the adhesive rub-ons, I put this along the bottom, and then I came back with the champagne foil, and obviously you've seen me do that, you didn't need to see that again. So now what I've done, and honestly I don't remember which of the word sets this is, but I've taken the word beautiful and I cut it off of the sheet so that it's still on that acetate backing, and I just need to come through and finish rubbing so that I can make certain that all of the letters are on the backing, the background here, and then I will just peel the acetate off. Now this time I'm going to use glitter. In fact, that's how this was done. This was another print that I took off the gel press plate, and I was testing. I wanted to see how this looks, and it looks fantastic. I mean, this is the Elizabeth Craft. This is the microfine silk glitter. It's super, super fine, and it just adheres, and it creates a really nice, crisp image. So what I'm going to do, now that I have the adhesive exposed, I'm just going to bring in a piece of paper. I'm going to use this to catch the color and then put it back into the jar. I don't know how well this is going to work because I want to mix two colors. Yeah, I think I'll mix two colors. So I'm going to put, you know what, I'm just going to use the pink. Let's not make this any harder than it has to be. So this is, I believe this is called Vintage Pink. And in fact, this is called Vintage Pink. So I'm just going to kind of push this around with my finger. I want to press and make certain that the glitter is firmly adhered to that stickum that's on there. This is super fine stuff. It's going to be everywhere for a couple of days, but it's worth it because I love glitter and I think this is going to look great. All right, so some of that's going to go in. Now, because this is glitter, excuse me, because this is glue, I can really give this a good flick and knock off the excess. And I'm just actually going to put this to one side. I will use the paper to kind of funnel all of that back into the jar in a little while when I'm done here. But in the meantime, let's grab a big mop brush, and I'm just going to brush off. Oh yeah, this was a good choice, just going with that pink. It looks really nice with the background color. So you can see what I have so far, and you see how simple it is to just go ahead and put glitter on that adhesive to get those letters. So now what I'm going to do, this is one of the moths from the, let's see if I can put my hands on it. This is from the Melage Tissue Wrap Collection. This is a Tim Holtz Ideology thing, and I've cut this moth out with the intention that what I want to do is just kind of lay it here on the edge so that it spans both the foil on the bottom and the area where there is not foil on the top. So what I like about this, because this tissue wrap is fairly transparent, you can see, I'm not going to glue this in place now, but you can kind of see the color of the foil through the wings, and I think that this is going to be really great when it's done. So finishing up, here's a piece. This is done with gold embossing powder. Same process that you saw me do a moment ago with the glitter is to just go ahead and peel the acetate off of the adhesive once it's on there, and then come in and apply the embossing powder, press it in place with your finger, and then just remove the excess. Now when you're using embossing powder, typically you don't want to flick like that because it tends to knock stuff off even in the areas where you want it to remain. But with this adhesive being so strong, that's not an issue at all. You can flick it really, really well and remove a lot of that excess glitter. The other thing that I want to come back and show you. So this is that piece that you might have remembered from a few minutes ago that I accidentally touched up here and made a gigantic mess. So I've cut this off. This is one of the new Dilutions paint pens. So all I'm going to do is just come in here and kind of mimic some of what's going on here just to add a little texture. If I want to add some dots or dotted area along the bottom like this, I can, just to kind of give it a little bit more interest so that it's not totally turquoise. And again, I'm just making very light lines here along the side. Obviously, because this is shiny, you would need to use, if you wanted to work and write directly on the foil, you have to choose a pen that is appropriate. I don't know. Let's see what happens. Yeah, the Dilutions paint pens are not meant to use on a glossy surface, so that's not going to work, but there are pens that will do that. So that's an option. The other thing that I want to show you is, as I said, this process works really well on very smooth surfaces. So this is one of our wonky wood houses. This is number 4, and it's kind of too tall to stand up entirely, but you can see that I put some of the foil here. This is another one of the wonky wood houses, number 4. Now there's fair amount of glare here. What I've done was I used the Finnevere Art Alchemy paint, opal, what is this called? This is Aqua Rose in the Opal Magic part of the line. Again, this tissue wrap from the Ideology, I put that on first. Actually, I take that back. I put gesso on first, a very kind of random coat on the sides and the front and the back. And then I used the Opal Magic. And honestly, I used my finger to just kind of put it on so that it was kind of varied in terms of how thick the paint was. And I wanted to definitely leave some areas showing through in the back. Once everything was good and dry, and I let this paint dry overnight, I wanted it to really be cured, I came in with one of the adhesive rub-ons, put it on there, and then this is the pink melon, I believe that's the color of the iCraft Deco Foil that I used. So, you know, there's lots of ways that you can use this. There are various options that are going to produce really, really nice results, from the simple to the really more complicated, where you start layering elements like I did on this collage. But all in all, this is a really simple, very effective product to work with.